ISIS is using social media to recruit Americans for deadly terrorist attacks. And the FBI says they can't track every post.
That warning comes after this week's shooting in Texas. And the government says there could be more attacks. Ephraim Graham has the story.
Elton Simpson and Nadir Sufi are the Phoenix roommates behind the Texas terror attack and the newest faces of homegrown terrorism. The director of the FBI says young recruits like them are being drawn in by ISIS's slick online messages. The terrorists are using hip-hop music, productions that mimic the popular Grand Theft Auto video game, images of handsome fighters, and promises of homes and security to sell a false version of life under ISIS rule.
You're speaking to them in a language they understand, video, moving imagery, and music. People do want to belong to tribes, and this is saying, join our tribe.
At least 53 Americans have been charged with trying to travel to Syria to join the fight with ISIS in the last year. But there may be thousands inside the United States consuming the terrorist online poison.
Back in February, the FBI director James Comey said that we have investigations ongoing into ISIS-related activity right now in all 50 U.S. states.
With Skype, Facebook, Twitter, and other social media, the FBI estimates it's posting some 90,000 messages every day, telling followers to kill where you are if you can't travel to Syria to join the fight.
Before the advent of this new technology and the growth of social media, how would you reach into the basements and bedrooms of American homes?
And while the ISIS connection may begin on social media, the FBI warns if ISIS does make contact with people here in the U.S., their conversations go dark because the terrorists steer them into encrypted communications and the government can no longer follow them, making them potentially even more dangerous. Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Well, it is amazing that this sort of low-tech group is actually so sophisticated that they can out-tech the United States of America and fool the FBI and have the FBI admit we can't track them all. We can't get to them. The fight here really, though, isn't about technology. It's about ideology. And we have to convince people that following this kind of ideology, it's not going to get you to heaven. It's not going to get you to some utopia here on earth. It's not going to happen that way. What's it going to get you? It's going to get you death. That's what it's going to lead to. And we have to preach that message. We have to come straight at the ideology and have a war of ideas, not a war of bullets. So far, we haven't been willing to engage in that. We keep insisting this is a religion of peace. We keep insisting that somehow or other these are terrorists and we can't even associate Islam with them. You have to say they're terrorists. You can't say they're Islamic terrorists. Until we get to the point where we say we have to have a war of ideas and your ideas about God are wrong, if you think you blowing yourself up is going to get you straight to heaven, if you think taking out weapons and cutting people's heads off is the path to heaven, you're wrong. Until we start waging that war, we're not going to win this. Well, in other news, people gathered across the country Thursday to pray for our nation. This is spiritual warfare and its leaders on our annual National Day of Prayer. Jennifer Wishon has that story.
At this church in Mitchellville, Maryland, people could drive through for prayer.
We felt this would be an opportunity to just reach out to them for a few moments as they drive on by, just like they drive up to McDonald's window.
Everyone was invited.
I'm here so I can be prayed for.
We've been able to join in prayer together, thinking about our communities, thinking about public safety.
I pray for peace, for safety, not only for law enforcement, but for the community.
The theme for this year's National Day of Prayer was, Lord, hear our cry from 1 Kings.
Hear the cry and the prayer of your servant that is praying in your presence today.
On Capitol Hill, decision makers humbled themselves before God.
It is times like this when we bow our head in prayer.
Some presidential candidates took time to pray, including Senator Ted Cruz.
We pray for our leaders and ask that you give them wisdom.
Dr. Ben Carson was there too.
It is up to us, who are the true believers now, to stand up for what we believe, to have the courage and the faith to believe that God will get us through this difficult period.
If the believers would just take one day and everybody pray at the same time, about the same, could you imagine what God would do? That's what the National Day of Prayer is about.
Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Washington.
Well, now more than ever, we need to pray and we need to ask God to intervene. Without the Prince of Peace, we're not going to have any peace. So I encourage you to pray, set aside time, and don't just do it on the National Day of Prayer. We need to be praying continually and praying for our leaders.